What's up, King Cats? Welcome back to my channel. Look who's in the background. We know what that means, because this is not our house. We are at a show. Ta-da! So, we're in Indianapolis. We're here for the Indianapolis Battle of the States. Just got here a few minutes ago. It is Friday. We just drove up today since it was only a couple hours from Ohio. We just got everything settled into the room. Definitely much smaller and more modest than our room at the Ameristar, but that is okay. I'm about to eat a meal, so this is just some asparagus chicken, sweet potato, and peanut butter, and then I'm adding a rice cake to it for some extra carbs. I just took photos to send. Well, Jason asked for photos after meal three, but I wanted to see what I looked like after meal two, so I took some anyway. But then I'm supposed to send him stuff after meal three, which is this next one, which I will take those photos in like an hour and a half, 2 hours after eating this, and I will go to athlete check-ins, and then I will go get my tan at 7. But here is our lovely room. I mean, this is my face. So it's just a Westin, but this light in this bathroom. Hold on. Like, I know it doesn't look like it in, it looked better a minute ago. Maybe I was wrong. This light will be somewhat decent for makeup. If not, I actually do have my ring light with me this time because I wanted to make sure I had good light for progress photos. But I'm feeling very good this go around. We changed up my peak a little bit. So I peaked on lower carbs throughout the entire week, and then we're doing more loading today. So loading a bit today, pulling back water a bit today. I honestly feel really good. I feel much tighter and sharper than I did last week. I'm coming in about 3 to 4 pounds lighter here this week, which a lot of that is just fluid drop off, but excited. So let's get in to another show day vlog. Hope you're ready, because I am. So I'm gonna give you guys a couple show day hacks. This one I got from my bikini big sis, the lovely angel that's been helping me with my posing, Jessie. She was like, bring a candle. And I was like, as someone that loves candles as much as I do, I don't know how I've never thought of this before. So I have this one from Target. And this one, it doesn't have a label on it, but it's called Bookshop, I think. Yeah, it's called Bookshop. There's mom's frappuccinos in the back. But yeah, bring a little candle with you. It just makes it feel homier. Also, when you have the smell of spray tan on, it kind of helps cancel it. And then I'm taking this off my foot. I always bring slippers literally everywhere, so show day is no different. So first thing I did when I got here was unpack my black bedding, just so that it's all ready to go. I'm like, I need to get settled, get everything like where it needs to be, and then I can feel peace. So I'm gonna eat this meal, I'm gonna do some stuff, and that's about it. I might go for like a little stroll. Mom, would you like to go for a stroll with me, or are you gonna go swim?
I'll go for a stroll.
Okay, I figured that would be nice since we've been sitting in the car. So eat, stroll. Yeah, I'll probably make myself like my makeup look a little bit nicer before athlete check-ins. That's something that I do also, is I will wear like a nice outfit and, you know, look semi-decent at athlete check-ins if possible. Like if I don't already have my tan on, I just think it's a nice way to respect the sport, respect the promoters, like all that stuff. So that's just something that I've always been taught and always done. I forget who taught me that. It was either Becky Clausen at one of the first workshops I ever went to, or it was someone else. I don't know, but it's just something that I've always done. Also just makes you feel good. And there's photographers there for like NPC News Online and stuff, so I don't want to look like a total troll. So yeah, let's get into it. All right, guys, so I'm about to head to check-ins. One thing that I learned a long, long time ago, I forget who it was that taught me. It was either Becky at a symposium or it was Monty. Sorry, I'm not in focus. Mom is sneaking under. Is to wear something nice to check-ins. It doesn't affect your scoring at all. It doesn't affect your placing at all. It's just like a nice gesture and it makes me feel good. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just wearing this little dress from Target with my little Zara shoes. And then this actually works out perfectly because a lot of shows, including this one, require you to wear your suit bottoms underneath whatever you're wearing, like wearing it to check-in, so that if they need to check your suit bottoms for coverage, they can. So I just have my little suit bottoms on under this. We're gonna go to check-ins with a mask on, obviously. All right, good morning, guys. So it is obviously show day. Last night I went to check-ins, got my tan, just hung out with mom. We actually watched Shrek because it was on TV last night. But it is almost time for the athlete meeting. It's like 8:20, the meeting's at 8:30. Feeling good, already had my first meal for the day. Makeup and hair already done. I just need to have or I just need to put my lashes on, and then obviously my lipstick waits because this whole thing, but it's game day, so let's get it. All right, you guys, so, new suit, who dis? I told Lydia, I literally sent her a picture of a blue dragon with like gold scales. And I was like, this is basically the vibe that I'm going for. I think she nailed it. I really like the energy of this color suit. I don't know, this feels good. But I am fully ready. Lashes, lips, jewelry, suit, hair, the whole shebang. So, it's about time to go down to pre-judging. So, I'm gonna pack all my stuff up, and the next place I see you will probably be on stage. Let's do this thing.
Hey, Em, here with your mom. And we just want to say good luck, and we love you. You're gonna kill it in your new blue suit. Love you.
Relax. Let's go. Over the turn, please.
Third time's the charm. Now that we're not zoomed in, but you're gonna kill it. So excited to watch you smash up there. And
back to the question.
Like, it's getting slippery. All right, y'all. We are back stage. Figure I'll do this for my pump up carb today. So shout out Sour Strips. They don't pay me anything. They just send me stuff, which I'm down with. But I figured I'd bring the one that matches my suit. This is actually perfect because I need around 25 grams of carbs, so that's just full serving of these guys. Have about a quarter teaspoon of salt. And then we'll get it.
It's not coming out.
Also a little bit of water. That too.
66, Emily Duncan.
66!
Mary Davis. And 97, Catherine Diapolis.
Let's go, Em!
Let's go, 66!
Beautiful number 23.
Keep it tight. Beautiful, Emily.
Let's go, Em!
Turn to the rear, please.
Come on, Em!
66!
Face front.
Let's go, Emily!
Nice job, 66.
Nice job, Em.
See center stage, please. Competitor 66.
Woo! Let's go, Em!
Turn to the rear, please.
Yes, ma'am.
There you go, Em.
Face front.
Go, 66.
23, come between 66 and... can't see her name. 54.
Yeah, Tori.
Stay there.
Let's go, 66.
Face to rear, please.
I might still have been a
Take 4 steps to the curtain, please.
Nice job, Emily.
Face front, ladies.
Woo! Alright guys, so I just got off stage. It was a bigger class this time, but they still just brought us all out in one call out. So top three, because they took three of us and filed us off stage and let everyone else be compared after that. So that generally means you're in top three unless they change their mind. So outside of that, I have no idea what's happening, just because it's harder to tell when it's everybody all at once because you don't like know, but it is looking like top three, so gonna go rest up and see what happens.
You can't even like see my excitement.
I can see it in your movement. Here.
I'm smiling behind the mask, I promise.
Top three, baby.
I could hear all of you. I could tell like yes. Who everybody was. I was like, oh, that's Sue. Oh, that's Jesse. Oh,
Jesse's
that's
right around the
oh,
corner.
Oh, it felt good. It felt real good.
The blue looked super good.
Yeah, you like it?
Yes.
It felt good. It just felt like good energy. You know what I mean? It felt like a vibe. Hello, hello. Okay. So, how are you? No idea what else.
Jesse's right behind you. Okay, you're okay. You know, all that content for YouTube, hashtag. All right, guys, so it's about 3:30. We're gonna head down to finals because they actually started at 3, which is super nice, so hopefully we'll be out of here early. But I just wanted to, there's Nell. Come around the corner, everybody's favorite. And then there's Mom. She's gonna wait a little longer, but we're gonna go down to finals and let's hope some good stuff happens.
Let's hear it for competitor 66, Emily Duncan.
Feel my way through the darkness.
Let's hear it for competitor 85, Mary Davis. Catherine Diabolus. Fourth place goes to competitor 53, Rachel Mahan. Third place, competitor 66, Emily Duncan. Runner-up, second place, competitor 54, Megan.
So, I took third place at the Indie Battle of the States. I waited until finals were over so that I could just go right up to the judges and ask them for feedback. I also emailed them, but I wanted to be able to talk to all of them because normally when you get email addresses, you may only get one of the judges, you may get all of them, you may get a few, you just don't know. So I waited until finals were over so that I could go up to the judges and ask them for my feedback, you know, show them the photos that I had, be like, what do I need to do, especially going into national shows. My feedback was just largely literally this was the only thing they said. They were like, you just need to bring your backside in leaner, particularly your tie-in area. So it's literally just like the small little area of space. So I had 2 weeks to do that before Junior USAs. I just kind of kept my head down and like did the work that I needed to do. And then what we're gonna do in this video is we're gonna do two shows in one because I've been really bad about filming at shows because it's just not the first thing on my mind. So you're now gonna see the second half of this video. We're going right into Junior USAs, which is the first national show of the season. I just wanna like touch on this really quickly. When I first posted on Instagram that my feedback from the judges was to come in leaner for nationals, there were a lot of people that were like surprisingly off put by it and were saying like, oh, the judges don't know what they're talking about. How could you come in leaner? Da 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 da. And like I said on Instagram, you know, please don't say those things because that's disrespectful to the judges and what they are trained to do. Like, it actually does take a lot of work to become an actual judge. And the judges do know what they're talking about. And while in the context of like lifestyle people who are the people that are my primary audience, I am very lean and I acknowledge that. But bodybuilding is a sport and it's an extreme. So when you see a competitor that is already pretty darn lean in, you know, lifestyle terms being told to come in leaner, it can be like, but how? But in the context of bodybuilding, you can pretty much always be leaner. So I'm also somebody that I have incredibly high and short glute insertions. So if you see the girls that are on stage, especially the ones that beat me, they typically have, and like they don't beat me because of this, but they typically have lower and longer glute insertions. Like you'll see that, like they get that big like teardrop thing and their insertions are like much lower on their hamstring, if that makes sense. If you don't know anatomy or like what a glute ham tie-in is, this is all gonna go whoosh. And that's okay, because you don't necessarily have to know that, but I'm just like telling you something that I struggle with as a competitor. But having such high and short insertions makes it really hard for me up there, just because I don't have that big deep tie, or not big, but that long low tie that a lot of the girls have. So basically, the long story short of this little chat is I kind of have to just bring the conditioning to compensate for that. So we did as much as we could within 2 weeks, and so now you're gonna get to see how that turned out at Junior USA. So let's take a nice little flight over to Charleston, South Carolina, and it's Junior USA's time. What's up, King Cats? Welcome back to my channel. So I have my little mask here because I'm about to leave this room. If you can't read this, if you can read this, you're too close. But this is from Revolve, by the way. We're just diving right into things. But not our typical surroundings, because we are here, and by here, I mean Charleston, South Carolina, for Junior USAs. So I have a lot of feelings swirling. I have a lot of feelings swirling around right now, so I'm not gonna talk about that right now, but we're about to head down to check-ins. It's very early. It's like 8:15 in the morning on Friday. So I'm gonna head down to check-ins. I might get some clips. That's why I'm filming this intro clip now. But yeah, first national show of the year. Let's go. All right, so it's so humid. Like, in case you couldn't tell by the fact that I look like I've used a lot of Facetune. You'll see her clearly more later. This is Anna Kate. She was actually in the overall with me at St. Louis. But we are walking to check-ins. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a chill day. I'm gonna stop this clip because you can't see shit, but we're going to check-ins. It's just fitness and then bikini, so we'll be done fast. All right, so it's not a show without a blowout. There's Miss Sue B, looking so pretty.
All right, just trying to smile.
And you can't tell. And there's Anna Kate. This is your first dry bar, right?
Yeah.
How did you like it?
Good.
Yeah.
I like it. It's got massage sauce.
So now we all have pretty hair. We're all checked in. And next is tan. I don't have my, oh yeah, I got it. My hands look disgusting. Anna Kate's nails look nice. Mine don't. I need to go put my nails on. And then my tan's not until like 7, so I got time.
Hello, everyone. Why am I laughing already? But good morning. It's show day. This vlog probably is pretty subpar so far. I'm just gonna say that because I just haven't like been wanting to film. But I want to show you this real quick. The little ones are deflated, but Chanel had this Wonder Woman balloon sent to my room. Love that. But no, that was seriously so sweet to come here too. So I got here on Wednesday. I'm in Charleston, South Carolina for Junior USAs. If you're not familiar with bodybuilding and like how all of it works, Junior USAs is the first show of the season. It's the first national show of the season, or the first pro qualifier of the season. So you do have the chance to win your pro card here. Excuse me. So at this show, it's a little bit different than a lot of the other shows. At this show, only the top, it used to be 3, but now it's top 4 since there's more height classes now. But the top 4 in the overall earn their pro cards in bikini. So what that means is class A through H. It's divided by height. You have to win your class, and then when you go for the overall comparison, you have to get top four in the overall comparison. So I'm H class because I am tall. The cutoff for the tallest class is 5'7", and I am 5'9", even though the NPC has never measured me at the same height. I've been measured here, not like here specifically, but it like shows at 5'9", at 5'8", 5'8½", like anything in between. So I'm, like when I talk about my height, I go by what my doctor says. And at my doctor's office, I'm 5'9", so whatever. But regardless, I am always in just whatever the tallest class is. But anyway, yeah, I just haven't really been like wanting to film a ton while I've been here. One, I mean, you know, Thursday was really just working and kind of getting my bearings. Friday was kind of running around doing check-ins in the morning. Once again, working. What have we got? Blowout, tan, all of that stuff. But honestly, I just came into this show, like, I didn't talk about coming here on social media at all, like, I didn't share anything, and I just, like, needed that for myself, just because, just for a lot of reasons that I don't necessarily, like, need to get into a video. I'm not trying to, like, hide things from you guys, but, like, at the end of the day, I do this for myself and nobody else, and so just, like, I was in kind of a weird mental headspace after the indie show. The feedback that I got there was absolutely needed in order for me to bring what I'm bringing here today. But it was a rough couple of weeks, and like I'm not gonna try and lie to anyone about that. I'm not gonna try and BS anyone about that. And somebody on one of my posts where I was like talking about not being happy with getting third at indie, they were like, oh, are you just some spoiled brat that's used to winning everything? And I'm like, no. No athlete competes for third, especially not when you're going to the first pro qualifier of the season 2 weeks later. I just want to clear that up. I never want to give that impression that like I'm not grateful for anything, but also like I don't want third at a regional show. But it was this swift kick in the literal rear that I needed, and like the feedback that I needed to make sure that I'm doing, or that I did everything that I could to get here at the best that I could be, if that makes sense. And so just coming into this, also, like, this may sound weird coming from me because I do social media, but, like, this is a show where it's just a lot of people from social media, and, like, I'm very much, like, obviously I have my friends and stuff, but I'm very much so, like, a more keep-to-myself kind of a person, and I'm very introverted, so, like, large groups of people overwhelm me a lot. And so I just my really close friends knew, obviously, like Sue and Alex knew they're here because Sue's competing, and like Alex is one of my coaches. Like Nick Comedina knew because he's gonna be here. Like the people that needed to know, not needed to know, but like the people that I wanted to know knew. And that's really all I needed. And I just didn't want it to be a thing where like I got any kind of distracted because of social media, whether it would be from like answering comments or DMs or whatever about just like from you guys just offering genuine support, and please don't take that as me like not appreciating that. But like I just didn't want any distraction from that. I didn't want any distraction from like people being like, oh, I didn't know you were coming, like I'd love to come say hi, like people that I know through social media kind of a thing. Like I'll see everyone that I want to see that like didn't know about it, you know, if we're meant to see each other kind of thing. I guess the long story short that I'm getting at, and I really don't want to sound like an a-hole saying that, like people are probably listening to that and being like, oh my god, she's so snobby, she doesn't want to hang out with anyone, she doesn't want to do this, she doesn't want to do that. I just needed to be able to focus and like do what I need to do and like keep to myself a little bit and just like get centered. Because also like when I got here, not only did like I have a slightly weird energy just like coming into it, but then when I got here I felt like a different kind of weird energy because I was reminded of the last time I was here when I missed my pro card by single digit points, because the last time I was here in 2016, I won my class but missed it in the overall. So like I felt that kind of weirdness and had to work through that and like let that go. And even up until last night, I had this like nervousness that I've never had, or like haven't had in a long time, but it was a very unique kind of nervousness, and that's why I say I've never had it before. So I just wanted to like let that run its course, and thank goodness I woke up this morning and just felt like very peaceful, very like I didn't feel that way anymore. I feel a lot calmer now. So it's amazing the things that a good sleep will do. And I'm just ready to go. So it's one of those things where, and you guys know me as like the intense person, and that is very true. Like that is who I am. And so it's even difficult for me to say this, but I've also had to have the internal dialogue with myself of, hey dude,
You've been off stage for over 4 years. You've not been on a national level stage in over 4 years. You genuinely don't know how things are gonna turn out today. And as much as I want to win, and as much as I wanna make, you know, top callouts, as much as I wanna win, as much as I wanna turn pro at this show, like, I have to be okay with the fact that I've been away from this for a long time. And that is such a hard pill to swallow, even though I know that logically in my head, and I know that the division has changed since I've been off stage and all that stuff. And so just like working, and there's even more like that's been swirling up around here that I am not even saying, like, in regards to all that, because like it doesn't matter to most of you, because like most people watching my stuff don't compete. So just me like bull about all of it isn't really gonna help anybody. But there's just been like a lot going on in my mind about how this is going to go. And obviously, like, my big desire is to go pro, obviously, otherwise I wouldn't be here. And I'm not gonna lie, like, I'm getting emotional and I can't cry because I have a tan and makeup on. There were a couple instances over the last couple weeks, like especially right after I got third at Indy, I was like, do you even belong there? Like, should you even be going to a national level show? And like, I questioned myself more than I ever have within this sport. And like, it got me thinking about like my last season. I was like, you never questioned yourself that whole time. Why? But for whatever reason, I just started questioning myself more. And I'm not religious anymore, so I don't ascribe to a particular religion, but like, I do still like meditate and have a spiritual practice, and like, I guess you could consider it pray. And I was praying last night, and like, and I speak out loud when I do it. And when I was doing it, like, and like, I don't script it or anything. It's just like whatever comes out. And like, it was just like, Jesus. And one of the things that came out was, you're still here for a reason. You are still literally here. You got here for a reason. And so you've got to fight for that reason, whatever it is. And I feel a lot better this morning. I felt just like peaceful, good energy waking up. And it's kind of nice to go into a show like under the radar kind of a thing. And because it just allows me to focus on showing up and doing what I need to do. So I am all made up. Obviously don't have lipstick on yet because I will have a mask on, and I won't go on stage for like another 3 hours, maybe 3.5. It's very interesting, like, shows with COVID, because this one in particular, they're literally sending us there in blocks of time. So they're like, A, get here at X time, 30 minutes later, B, get here, 30 minutes later, C, get here, all this stuff. So it's very different than, and like, all the shows have obviously been different in their own way, but definitely very different formatting and setup and just like overall vibe and feel and stuff. So that's probably contributed to kind of some of the weird feelings too, is it just feels very different because the world is very different right now. But yeah, so I'm just gonna rest up. I have my little nails on. Paige made me, you probably can't see them, I'll put the clip here that I took last night. But I'm Scottish, and our family motto, I don't speak Latin, so I'm probably butchering this, is disapati, which means learn to endure or learn to suffer. That's the Duncan clan motto. So she hand lettered on these nails, disapati. I told her I wanted it to be subtle enough where it was there, but that like obviously the judges couldn't see it. So I wanted it to be a thing where it was just like something that I could see. And then the thumbnail on the other side, because there's only 4 letters in the second word, is a glyph for transformation. So I felt that that was appropriate. So I'm going to just continue to rest. I'm going to eat here in a little bit, in about half an hour, and then we'll get into it. I love you guys, and I hope this clip is a lot less long than my little timer's telling me right now, because 50% of the people probably clicked out of the video just from this clip. Okay, bye.
You here.
Hi, Alan.
A little flat, but I mean, one
meal. But one meal and a pump in.
Because some pull-throughs just really pumped up your glutes, just like you did for Indy.
Yeah.
Be perfect. This is good. I'm really happy.
I'm excited. I feel a lot better this morning.
Yeah, you should. You should.
I feel like, I think it was a Harry Potter marathon last night. That made me feel real nice. Did you guys watch it?
No.
Oh, no, it was great. But just like, I went to bed at like, I think like 8:30. And then I woke up at 3:30, or I woke up at 2:45, just kidding.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I feel just like, I feel less anxious, yeah. Which is good. I feel like more peaceful and more good. Just of like the, instead of like, still slightly wounded animal, but like more so like wounded wolf ready to still hunt some shit.
Right.
So it's kind of a good thing.
Yeah.
Like underdog kind of vibe.
A little first time having that feeling.
Yeah.
All right, you guys. So, I'm off. I'm ready. It's time to go. First national show of the year, but I'm not gonna bring my vlogging camera to pre-judging just because it's gonna be super rushed back there, but Alex has my nice camera so we can get stage footage for Sue and I, and it's time. I feel good. I'm ready to go. So, I'll see you on stage.
Let's go,
Em! Let's go, Em!
Let's go, Em!
Woo! Let's go, Em!
He's such a 180
face up that wall. Come
on, Em! There you go, Em!
Yeah, baby!
So I'm gonna wrap up this video here. Obviously I'm in the same location as the update that I gave you between Indy and Charleston. We're just gonna pretend that you don't know, whatever. But I took home 7th at Junior USA's. I ended up not getting any clips at finals on accident because I didn't give Alex my camera, and competitors weren't allowed in the venue. We were only allowed, because of COVID, they had us in like this random backstage area that wasn't in the actual building itself, and then we had to walk to the building to the actual backstage area, and it was definitely very different than anything I've ever done. But I am just really grateful that they're making things happen within the COVID guidelines, and that, you know, this sport cares enough about its athletes to do literally everything they can, and the promoters involved do everything they can to bend over backwards to make sure that we still have our chance. So definitely was not the ideal placing in terms of, you know, what I would want. Obviously, you don't get pro by getting 7th, but it is a matter of, you know, I've been off stage for over 4 years and the division has changed and evolved, and it's far more competitive now. So that just means I have to be that much better to be as competitive as I've been in the past. And so it's a tough pill to swallow, but I mean,
I'm gonna swallow that mother effer and do everything that I can with it. So it's national show circuit time. It's time to get better, and that's it. So I didn't get any other clips that night either because I actually had to like rush and pack everything up to fly out the next morning. So sorry these vlogs have kind of been not as great as some of my older show day vlogs. I'm gonna be trying to be better at ones in the future. But anyway, I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all of your support. I know I've been keeping a lot quieter just like leading up to shows and on show days and stuff. And I just need that for my peace and my like mental health and my focus to divert my attention where it needs to be. But you guys still show up and show out when I do share, and that truly does mean the absolute most to me. So I do still want to involve you guys, and that's why I continue to film what I do film of shows. But yeah, so thank you for being here for the ride. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for loving me. I love you. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, subscribe to the channel, send some good energy my way if you are an energy sending type person, and I love you. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.